In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear brother and sister, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and warm welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's readings. It's the 28th of March, Saturday of the fourth week of Lent. The Holy Gospel according to John, chapter 7, verses 40 to 53. At that time, when they heard the words of Jesus, some of the people said, "This is really the prophet." Others said, "This is the Christ." But some said, "Is the Christ to come from Galilee? Has not the scripture is descended from David and comes from Bethlehem, the village where David was?" So there was a division among the people over him. Some of them wanted to arrest him, but no one laid hands on officers. Then went back to the chief priests and Pharisees, who said to them, "Why did you not bring him?" The officers answered, "No man ever spoke like this man." The Pharisees answered them, Are you led astray, you also? Have any of the authorities or of the Pharisees believed in him?" But this crowd, who do not know the law, are accursed. Nicodemus, who had gone to him before and who was one of them, said to them, "Does our law judge a man without first giving him a hearing and learning what he does? They replied, "Are you from Galilee too? Search and you will see that no prophet is to rise from Galilee." They went each to his own house. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Brothers and sisters, we are in the season of Lent, and every day we are invited by the Mother Church to know a little more about Jesus, whom we follow, and to whom we have dedicated our lives. Do we know Jesus? Yes, indeed. From childhood, we have heard about him from our parents, relatives, friends, and catechism teachers. As we grew up, we also heard about Jesus each time we went for the Holy Eucharist. We also read some books, including the Holy Bible, especially the New Testament that speaks about Jesus. Even having done all this, the basic question remains: do we know who Jesus is? Do we know who Jesus is? A few people who went to meet Jesus heard him preaching and teaching, and they concluded he should be a prophet, one who speaks mysterious hidden things, one who predicts future events from divine past, one who speaks in the name of God. But Jesus was more than a prophet. There was also another group of people who went to Jesus. They called him Christ, anointed, the Messiah, the Son of God. But among them, there was a discussion on his origin. According to a few, the Messiah could not come from Galilee. He should be a descendant of David and come from Bethlehem. They failed to know the complete details of Jesus. The officers who were sent by the Jews and the Pharisees also heard Jesus talking and react differently. Like this, they said. Finally, we have Nicodemus, who challenges the Pharisees. Does our law allow judging someone before he is listened to? In other words, before you pass a word on Jesus, go and listen to him. Have a personal experience with Jesus. All that I have heard about Jesus is insufficient to speak about him I need to listen to him. Only when I listen to him and experience him personally will I know my Lord. Brothers and sisters, as we get ready to pray the psalm of the day, let's remember all those who are suffering from the coronavirus. Day by day, the number of the positive are increasing. From the epicenter of COVID-19. And as I was preparing this reflection, 88 new cases take coronavirus count near 700 in India and 700 in India and 16 dead. Let's pray for them. Let's pray for doctors and nurses. Psalm number 7 speaks about putting hope in God, who will save us from our enemies and be with us. Let's deepen our faith in God, especially like this, and let's pray that psalm. O Lord my God, in you I take refuge. Let's say, O Lord my God, in you I take refuge. O Lord my God, in you I take refuge. My God, in you I take refuge. Save me from all my pursuers and rescue me, lest I become like the lion's prey, to be torn to pieces, with no one to rescue me. In you I take refuge. Do me justice, O Lord, because I am just, and because of the innocence that is mine. Let the malice of the wicked come to an end, but sustain the just, O searcher of heart and soul, O just God. Our response, O Lord my God, in you I take refuge. A shield before me is God, who saves the upright. A just judge is God, a God who punishes day by day? Our response, O Lord, my God, in you I take refuge. Today being Saturday, created to honor our Heavenly Mother, let's pray the novena prayer to Our Lady of Mount Carmel. Holy Mother of God, we greet you as Queen and Mother of Carmel. You were raised Mother of Carmel. You were raised from being a lowly handmaid to the great dignity of Mother of the Word Incarnate. We dedicate ourselves as an act of filial homage. We glorify the Holy Trinity by honoring you, recourse to your protection and your powerful intercession. Jesus, your Son, was so obedient to you on earth, will certainly grant your petitions on our behalf. With this trust and unbounded confidence, we beseech you to hear and obtain for us of your divine Son the favors we request in this novena. Having experienced the efficacy of your prayers, we are full of confidence that you will gain for us this favor, if it is for the glory of God and for our good. Amen. Glory of God and for our good. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is world without end. Amen. Our Lady of Mount Carmel, pray for us. Thanksgiving prayer. Holy Mother of God and Queen of Carmel, we, your children, come before you in a spirit of filial as mother of our spiritual life. You have obtained for us innumerable graces and blessings from our Heavenly Father, who has given to us through you the greatest of all treasures, Christ our Lord. We recognize with deep sentiments of thankfulness all the spiritual favors that have come to us through your powerful intercession. In particular, we thank you for your special protection over those who wear your holy scapular with faith and love. And finally, we thank you for answering our prayers in our personal needs. We implore from you the great grace of final perseverance, that we remain faithful to the end to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. Pray for God's blessing, my dear friends. May the Lord Jesus be with you to defend you. May he be with you to sustain you. May he go before you to show you the way. May he follow you to guard you. From above, Spirit, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. This is Father Stifan Perera. And today, as we find in the Bible diary, Desmond DeMello from celebrating his birthday, also Dr. Lisa D'Souza from Ranipura, Lidwin Lasrado from Mumbai, Crystal Myra DeMello from Dubai. We wish them happy birthday and we pray God's choicest blessings on them. We pray God's choicest blessings on them. and also the others among the listeners of Carmel Light. Happy birthday to all of you. God bless you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. If you wish from my hand, kindly WhatsApp your full name and place to my number. Also, I will send you the daily mass link 9481263229. 9481263229. Bye-bye.